Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. My name is Monica and today we're at a different angle because I've got stuff on my desk. My desk is full. So I put the camera up here and it's not terrible. It's just different. So today's gonna be a short video, whatever, as it is, just because I unfortunately found like an actual total dud from ShopMIssA and I'm really disappointed because I really wanted it to like work out so that we had a more affordable option, but we're really not honestly lacking in affordable options for this type of product, and that is eyeshadows. So I have four palettes here from ShopMIssA and I hate three of them. So we're gonna talk about them. I'll show you some swatches, but the moral of the story is unfortunately ShopMIssA has some great awesome products. Their eyeshadows just aren't one of them. Alright, so palette number one is called the Wildflower palette, and technically it's like a bunch of singles that they put together in this palette. I like the palette itself, it's a nice empty Z palette, so I'm probably gonna just get rid of the singles and keep the actual palette because it's good quality. But I hated this palette. The mattes didn't blend, they were patchy, the shimmers looked terrible, even with the glitter glue, it just wasn't working and it just wasn't happening, and I couldn't get a look out of this that I liked. And don't even think about trying to wear this through a full work day. It does not last. It's just so that was my first disappointment. So after I tried out this one, and actually before I finished testing it out, I picked up three of like their newer bigger palettes. So they have the Self-Made palette, the Violets Are Blue palette, and the Over the Rainbow palette, and only one of these I can recommend to you. Let's talk about the Self-Made palette first. I have to say, at first, this was kind of a confusing color story. I wasn't sure if I really liked it, but I found a few like shades I really wanted to work with. I tried a few things. I tried a few of the shimmers out, and I will say, in these bigger palettes, the mattes are much better. The mattes are gorgeous. They blend really well, and they're not 100% pigmented. You really have to build it up, but they do blend, which is kind of what I'm looking for in a matte. I have to say the shimmers in here are garbage. They don't last. They're not really pigmented. You have to build them up. Even when you use a glitter glue with them, they're just really not there. And that's what I'm looking for in a good affordable palette. I want decent mattes, even if I have to build them up, as long as they're decent. And I want shimmers that'll last on my lid. And even with like giving it the best chance, priming, using a glitter glue, everything, the shimmers did not last. Unfortunately, I had the same experience with the Violets Are Blue palette. So this color story was, at least to me, a lot more cohesive. You've got like these purples and blues up here, and then you've got a lot of nice neutral tones down here. So I thought for some people, this could be a really nice everyday palette, but then like on your days you want to dress it up a bit more, you have the colors. Again, I tried this out. The mattes were decent, but the shimmers were garbage. And this is about a third shimmers. So I don't feel comfortable recommending this because I know I wouldn't reach for any of the shimmers in here, and when you've got like a third to a half of the palette shimmers, yeah, it doesn't matter how affordable it is. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Now, the only palette I actually liked and can recommend is an all matte palette from them, and this is the Over the Rainbow palette. This is an entirely matte rainbow palette. I really liked this one. You've got a lot of shades to choose from here. I like the color story. I liked the different tones that they picked for this, but this is one out of four. The rest of the palettes I tried out were really bad, and this is like really the only good one. So I think if you're interested in trying something specifically from ShopMIssA, go for this or find a palette from their brand. These are all from their in-house brand. Find something that's mostly matte, if not all matte, because from in my experience, their mattes aren't the best I've ever tried, but they're usable and they're workable. Whereas their shimmers are just trash. I cannot get the shimmers to work. So yeah, short video. So before we jump into my final thoughts, I'll just throw in a montage of all of the swatches here so you can kind of get an idea about what I'm talking about.
So you can cross me off that list, but if you're unsure, I insist you keep me on a little longer. I'd like you like before, but first I've got to be sure, because if I am not for myself, who the fuck am I gonna be for tonight? So treat me like I like, if only for a night. I'm not demanding, things I thought I want, but staring at this paper cup, I saw a little wider, and other things have happened to me up and down this avenue. We can sit back and let fate decide, but I, this insatiable hunger tonight, so treat me like I like, if only for a night.
All right, so those are all the swatches, and those are my thoughts on eyeshadows from ShopMIssA. Like I said at the beginning of the video, we're not really, at this point, thankfully, we have a lot of options when it comes to really good, affordable eyeshadow palettes. I have quite a few videos on my favorite affordable eyeshadow palettes. I'll throw a couple up in the cards, and I'll throw some down in the description box below to give you guys an idea. But even though ShopMIssA doesn't have good eyeshadow palettes, they have a lot of other awesome, affordable products, like their makeup sponges, their concealer, their foundation. I've got quite a few videos on ShopMIssA, like hits and holy grails you can definitely check out. Just their eyeshadows they're not it. So a quick video, but I just wanted to come on and give you my thoughts because I finally had time to thoroughly test out every single ShopMIssA palette that I picked up. So it's your friend editing Monica back again. I didn't make this clear in this video, though I said it in another video, but the Wildflower palette, the one of all the singles, I received that in PR. So that was gifted to me by ShopMIssA. The rest of the palettes I did purchase with my own money. So thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know down below what you think about ShopMIssA eyeshadows if you have tried them out, and if not, what you think you might want to pick up instead. Again, check out those other videos where I talk about my favorite affordable palettes, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Bye.